Good morning, friends. So we discussed about in a last class what is the potentiometer and so to find out the EMF of the two cells, also to find out the internal resistance of the given cell R is equal. Okay, so. And also based on some problems discussed in a last class. Today, so some problems are discussed in a current electricity. Okay? Right. So now one problem is taken.
Parallel. So what is the total EMF? And total internal resistance. And so under what condition in the current is drawn from the circuit from mixed grouping of cells is maximum. Okay, got it. So now first of all, same cells of each EMF and internal resistance are connected in a parallel. Okay, got it. Second cell, third cell, M cells are connected. So the number of cells are also connected. Okay. So that means E1, R, and E, R, and L. So E, comma, R. What is the nth resistor? The cell. Okay, got it. So EMF of the cell E and so E. EMF of the cell E. And so M cells each of EMF A and internal resistance are connected in a parallel combination. So what is the total EMF? What and internal resistance? And here given that information, okay, from the circuit, here E is the EMF of the cell, R be the internal resistance of this cell. Okay, now here in a parallel combination, so the total effective resistance in parallel combination, total effective resistance, that is called 1 by R effective is equal 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R2 R3 R R. Okay, this is etc. So now substituting in the equation, so 1 by R effective is equal 1 by R plus 1 by R plus 1 by R etc. Okay, M by R, number of cells is connected in M cells. Okay, the total is M cells. So 1 by R effective is equal M by R. So that is R effective is equal to, okay, so R by M. So this is called as a total internal resistance of the M cells. Okay, got it. Now, so what is the total EMF? The total EMF means, so the total EMF is equal to individual cell of the EMF. The total EMF, is equal to E, we can write. So because the EMF of the each cell, individual cell, is equal to the total EMF of the cell. So now here connected to external resistance. Okay, so that means here, that is the total EMF is nothing but individual cell of the EMF in a series combination is equal. Okay, the total EMF in a series combination, individual resistance, individual EMF is equal total EMF of the circuit. And also here, what condition is drawn? Mixed grouping of the cells. What condition is drawn? Maximum current. Mixed grouping of the cells. Okay, mixed grouping of the cells. This is called as a mixed grouping of the cells. So what condition? The maximum current is drawn from the circuit. So maximum current is drawn from the circuit. So based on the condition, okay, so the internal resistance, the total internal resistance is equal to the external resistor, that particular condition is called as a, the maximum current is drawn from the circuit, so according to the Wave's law, Ohm's law, V is equal IR, so I is equal V by R, okay, so I is equal, we can write E by R, so I is equal E R, means total resistance, we can write, so R plus small r by M. Okay, I is means the total current is equal EMF of the cell by R plus, that is the total internal resistance, total external resistance, that means total resistance, I is equal E by R plus R by M. So I is equal to, so cos r is taken M and R M by R by E. So that means is equal to E M by R M plus R. Okay, so in this particular condition, R is equal to, that means so small r is equal, that means if in case of R is greater than capital R. Okay, so EM by R M. So that means here in this condition, if in the condition, so the internal resistance is equal external resistance, the maximum current is drawn from the circuit. Okay, got it.
a battery of EMF 2.5 volts. Okay, and internal resistance small r is connected in series with a resistor of 45 volts through an ammeter resistance one ohm and the ammeter reads a current of 15 milliamps. Current 50 milliamps. Draw the circuit diagram and calculate the value of small r and calculate small r. Okay, value of small r. Okay. So now here given that information. So a battery of EMF 2.5 volts and internal resistance is small r connected in a series. That means so EMF of the cell. So that is called as EMF of the cell. And internal resistance small r is connected in a series. And with a resistor of 45 ohms. So 45 ohms external resistance R is equal to 45 ohms is connected through an ammeter resistance 1 ohm. R dash is equal to 1 ohm. And so ammeter reads a current E is 50 milliamps. Okay. And so draw the circuit diagram, calculate the small r, so the small r value. So EMF is given, E is equal to 2.5 volts. Okay, so the EMF of the cell and some resistance, that is a small r, connected in a series. Okay, and with a resistor of 45 ohms, through a ammeter, internal resistance R dash is equal to 1 ohm, and to measure the 50 milliamps current is measured. So draw the circuit diagram and so what is the internal resistance? So now given that information, so E is equal to 2.5 volts. Also, that is R is equal to find out R dash is equal to ammeter resistance 1 ohm and the reading of the ammeter amps. So 50 milliamps, that is equal 50 into 10 to the power of minus 3 amps. Okay, right. So external resistance R is equal to 45 ohms. So the calculate the small r. So according to the definition, V is equal to IR. I is equal E by R. R means so capital R, small r, R dash. Okay, that is okay. R dash, small r, and capital R. E by. Okay, right. So I is equal. So what is the value of this small r? Okay. So I is means the current is passing through the 0.50 into 10 to the power of minus 3 amps.
Okay, E is equal 2.5 by R. R is means 45 plus 1 plus R plus 1. R dash. R dash is equal 1 ohm. Okay. I is equal. So 50 into 10 to the power of 4 minus 3. I is equal. Okay. So here that is a 45 plus 1, 46. And so that is a 50 into 10 to the power of minus 3 is equal E by, okay, so that is means 2.5 by 46 plus R. Okay, so here 46 plus R is equal 2.5 by 50 into 10 to the power of 4 minus 3. Okay, so here point is taken 0. 20. Okay. 20 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So 10 to the power of minus 3 is taken plus 3. Okay. So 46, that is the E is equal to, E is means 2.5 volts by R. So that is a 46. Okay. So that is the R is equal to, okay. So 50 into, that is a 50 into 10 to the power of minus 3. 50 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So 2.5 by 2 is 1 by 20 into 10 to the power of 4 plus 3. Okay, got it. So now is taken 46 plus R. Okay. So now here 46 plus R is equal to, that is the here calculation. Here calculation. So 2.5 by, so 46. Okay. So 46 into R. So 46 means 50 into 10 to the power of minus 2. So 5 into 10 to the power of minus 2. 0 and 0 cancel. 5 into 10 to the power of minus 2. So 5, that is what is a here. 5 is a 25. Okay. So point 1 is cancel. So remaining we get 50. Okay. So small R is equal to 50 minus 46 is equal to 4 ohms is called as a internal resistance. Internal resistance. Okay, got it. So what is the ratio of the power dispersion?
Okay. So according to definition, power P is equal power P is equal V square by R. V square by R. P is equal power P is equal V square by R. V is means potential difference or voltage, and R is means the resistance. V is called as a voltage. R is called as a resistance. V square by R. And P is equal to V square by R. So for example, V is the constant because constant voltage. That is equal, if in case of P1 by P2 is equal, that is means R2 by R1. Okay, R2 by R1. So P2 by P1 is equal R1 by R2. That means R1 by R2 is equal P2 by P1. So that is R1 by R2 is equal to 1 is to 2 ratio. So 1 by 2. So that is equal as a P1 is to P2 is equal 2 is to 1 ratio is taken. Okay. So the power distribution P1 by P2 is equal. For example, V is the constant. So 1 by R. 1 by R is taken. That is equal as a P1 by P2 is equal R1 by R1, 1 by R2. That is R2 by R1. You can write directly. Also, so P2 by P1 is equal R1 by R2. So P R1 by R2 is equal to P2 by P1. That is R1 is to R2 is equal 1 is to 2. So P1 is to P2 is equal 2 is to 1 ratio. 2 is to 1 ratio. Okay, so the power and the resistance are inversal proportional relation. Okay, got it.
So what is the potential difference of 6 volts maintained between the heads? So what is the potential gradient? So E is equal, E is directly proportional L. E is equal pi into L. Pi is equal E by L. Okay, so E is given, that is equal. So EM, that is called as a volts, E is equal 6 volts. So that means 6 by L, L is equal 5, that is the pi is the gradient, potential gradient. So the potential gradient is equal 1.2. Okay, so 1.2, 5, 5 ones are 5 2 are. Okay, 1.2. And so next up to find out the EMF of cell. So EMF of cell, E is equal, E is directly proportional L. So E is equal pi into L, E is equal pi. So pi is equal is the potential gradient already to find out. So 1.2. L is equal length. So 1.80 meters. That is equal 2.16. Okay, volts. 1.26 volts. So that is the EMF of the cell. Okay. So the length of the wire, L is equal 5 meters, E is equal 6 volts. So that is called as a point balancing against the length is equal 18 centimeter of the potentiometer wire. Okay. So given that information, and according to the potentiometer definition, potentiometer formula, E is directly proportional L. Potential difference across any portion on the wire is directly proportional its length. So E is equal to pi into L. So the pi is equal to E by L. So this is called as the potential gradient. Pi is equal to potential gradient. So pi is equal to 6 by 5. So 1.2 something is taken. So according to the definition of the potential, so E is equal to pi into L. Pi is equal to potential gradient already to find out. L is equal as the length of the wire 1.8 centimeters is converting into the meters 1.8. So that will substitute it, we get the 2.16 volts. Okay, got it. Length by 5%. Calculate the percentage change in the resistance. Calculate the percentage change in the resistance. Change in the resistance. Okay, got it. So a cylindrical material wire is stretched to increasing its length 5%. Increasing the length, that is called as a increasing the length. I-N-C-R-E-A-S-E, increasing in length. So increasing the length, that is a delta L by L is equal 5%. Okay. So calculate the percentage change in the resistance. See. So that what is the relation between the resistance C and stretched wire, that is increasing the length, L is equal. So the resistance C is directly proportional L. Okay, the directly proportional L. And so R is equal, that is directly proportional to by the, so L into L means so L by, that is the area A, inversely proportional. So that is the L by L dividing and multiplying, because this taken volume. Okay, R is directly proportional L square by A into L is called as a volume. A into L is called as a volume. Okay, got it. So R is directly proportional L square by V. L is the constant, V is the constant. So in any equation we can write R is directly proportional, the relation between resistance C and length of the wire, R is directly proportional L square. Okay, so now the percentage change in the resistance C. Okay, so the percentage change in resistance C. Resistance C, percentage change in the resistance C. So the delta R by R. Okay, so the delta R by R is equal to 2 into delta L by L or DL by L. That means 2. So 2 is means 2 inside of the 2 like minus 1, this is the 1. And that is the 2L. That is the differentiating. So differentiating both sides. And that means, for example, D by DL into L square. That means 2 into L. That is equal to 2L. Here also delta R by DR by R. Delta R by R is also constant. Is equal to 2 into delta L by L or DL by L. So 2 means so the 2 is go to outside. 2, that is the differentiating. Okay. For example, so D by DX into X to the power of N is equal N into X to the power of N minus 1. N minus 1. So N is go to outside. N is over the system. Okay now. Here also 2 inside of the 2, 2 like this is the 1, a 1 last part. So 2 into delta L by delta R by R changing, delta L by L changing, percentage into percentage. Okay, so DR is taken delta R, what R is taken, DR means delta R is R equal. Okay, so delta R is the DR is the same. So that is the DR by R or delta R by R percentage is equal 2 into delta L by L is changing the length, that is called as a 5%. 5%, that is equal 10% is the percentage of change in the resistance C. 10. Okay, the 10% is change in the resistance C. Okay, right, got it?